Well, joining us now to talk about the movie Woodlawn is leading actor Caleb Castille. Caleb, it's great to have you with
Thanks
us
for
today.
Having me.
This is a film with a powerful message, and it's the true story of events that happened in the early 70s, but events that are about racial tension, about reconciliation. Boy, it sounds like today, doesn't it?
It sounds a lot like today.
How powerful an impact can a movie like Woodlawn have on our country today, do you think?
I think it can have an immense impact. I think that, you know, you look at the elements of the story and the problems of the story and the solutions to those problems, and, you know, as history does repeat itself sometimes,
it does.
You got to look back and see how we can take those same solutions and
How closely does this movie depict what really happened in Birmingham? How honest
well,
is it?
I think it's, I would say all the events of the story, I mean, even down to some of the scenes in the story are taken out of personal journals of people who were there and lived in that time. So it's pretty spot on.
How did playing this role impact your life?
Oh, tremendously. I think that as a young black male, it has impacted me greatly. It's put me in a place to where, you know, I can make an impact, a positive mm-hmm. impact. So I just take it as a blessing. It's great.
And that was really your goal in going out to L.A. and seeking to get into this industry. Not an easy egg to crack by any stretch of the imagination. Here you are. You wind up with the key role in a big film coming out. Talk a little bit about how that happened, because it happened in an unusual way.
Yeah, it did. Well, you know, I was playing football at the University of Alabama, and after my junior year, I just decided to take a different path of life, and I wanted to impact people in a different way. And so, given this opportunity, I can do that. And like you said, I mean, I didn't want to just take any role, any and every role. I wanted to take roles in stories that have purpose and that inspire people.
Yeah, and that paid off for you with this. Even though there was a place and time along the way where it didn't look like you were going to get the role you wanted. Talk about that.
Right, yeah. So I was originally casted as the stunt double because of my athletic ability. Uh-huh. And then 3 days before production, they bring me in after rehearsals and they say, hey, we want to look at you as the lead actor because we couldn't get the guy who we originally hired. And 3 days later, I'm playing the lead role.
I mean, that had to be such a stunning reversal of mm-hmm. circumstances to you, because it was your heart desire to get this role.
Right.
You wind up playing the stunt double without any knowledge that there was ever a question about anything. God opens the door and hands this to you.
Right, yeah. I think it was because God wanted me and everyone else to be able to look at that situation and show you that he's in control, and there was nothing I did.
Boy, that's the truth. You play Touchdown Tony Nathan mm-hmm. in this film. Tell us a little bit about Tony Nathan as a person.
Yeah, I mean, he's just, you know, you have these heroes in life. You have these people with such a legend about them, and when you think about those people, when you want to meet them, you hope they everything about them is true.
Yes.
That you've heard.
Yeah.
Tony is every bit of what I heard about him. He's just such a humble, incredible
human being. Kind of a quiet determination.
Yes, yes, very much so.
You know, Rosa Parks.
Yeah.
Same, I mean, that kind of, I'm going to stand, and I'm going to be, and I'm going to do.
Yeah, that's it. That's exactly how Tony was.
Yeah.
And he was a coachable young man. He just wanted to do the right thing with his gift.
Boy, that's, you know, that's such a great quality for any of us to be teachable, whether it's with a good coach or with God, you know, and you've had that coaching and teaching in your own life. How has that impacted you?
Oh, I mean, the coaching that I've had in life, whether it be from my father or Coach Nick Saban or my high school coach, Fred Yancey, it's been something that's got me to this point. Those men have helped mold me into the decision maker I am today. So it's been great.
Yeah. You said earlier on that you just didn't want to take any role when you went out to LA. Is that is that still sort of the premise of how you look at potential work?
Yeah, of course. I use my, you know, my relationship with the Lord gives me that spiritual compass, that moral compass. And so I think that I just want to do things that are honoring to him and also my family. So, and there's great things on both ends of the spectrum. So I think that's where I'm blessed to be in the situation I am.
You know, I think of when I read your story, I think of, for example, Joseph in the Bible, where God had a plan and a purpose to use him in a mighty way, even to impact his nation, as this could, our nation at this time. But there was a training period in between. And maybe the biggest part of the training period is the end, you know, just before the open door. Yeah. And those 2 years out in LA had to be a rough 2 years. Did you ever question, you know, am I doing the right thing by holding out for the right role?
Well, no, because I took myself out of it a long time ago. I just wanted to be able to use, you know, my craft and my interests and the strengths and talents that God has blessed me with to just be a light, just be a positive light. And so not for one second did I think it was wrong.
What's in the future for you? What do you see down the road, or what would you like to see?
Well, I would definitely like to see more roles come my way that are purposeful and life-giving and that can impact people and give them entertainment at the same time. So I'm just looking forward to see what God has next for me.
You're young, you're talented, and you've got strong character. Don't compromise.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Hang in there. Caleb, thank you for joining us. And we want you to learn more about the movie Woodlawn. To do that, go to woodlawnmovie.com. It's awesome. You are going to love it. There you're going to find testimonies, blogs, and even devotionals. The movie opened last weekend. It's in theaters nationwide, and you do not want to miss it.